Hello everyone, this is our second lecture for engineering chemistry. In this we are going to discuss what are the water softening method. In our previous video we have been discussed that how the water get contaminated with the different salts of calcium and magnesium, like calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium bicarbonate and magnesium sulfate. Then how, due to this, water acquires some properties, and that is called as a hardness, and this hardness is a water quality parameter. Now water softening methods are those which are going to create a hardness, that those are soap destroying properties. We have discussed this in our previous lecture. Now water softening method means the process which removes or minimizes the amount of hardness producing ions with the help of various chemicals, and those chemicals are zeolites, umberlite IR 120, then lime soda. Now recently one membrane is there, that is called as reverse osmosis process. Nowadays what happens here, in our previous lecture we have discussed that this means this hardness have two types, temporary and permanent. Now this permanent hardness, this requires some chemicals like these zeolites, umberlite and lime soda, such membranes. But the temporary hardness which do not require any of the chemicals, it is removed by mere boiling. Now in water softening, why it is required? We have discussed the disadvantages also, because in industry hard water is not desirable because it interferes in many of the dyeing industries, pharmaceutical industries, and the results are not desired. Means in pharmaceutical industry another derivative may go created, then in dyeing industry the shades will be affected, in paper industry paper will not be a white and of good quality, in cloth industry or in textile industries again the shades may be affected, quality of that cloth may be affected. So water softening methods are very essential in the industrial field. Now water softening method means what? Which the methods, the processes which are used to remove or minimize the hardness of the water. Now first of all, here we are going to discuss, there are various methods of water softening. First is zeolite, second is ion exchange, third is lime soda, fourth is reverse osmosis process. Lots of processes are there. Zeolite method is also called as a permutite method. Now in zeolite method, here we are going to discuss zeolite. Now what are zeolites? Now zeolites are the inorganic polymers. Now these are naturally found as well as we can prepare them in a laboratory. They have general formula of sodium oxide, that is Na2O, Al2O3, XSiO2 and YH2O, where X is a number which varies from 2 to 10, means it may have 2 to 10 molecules of silicon dioxide. Y varies from 2 to 6, means it is associated with 2 to 6 water molecules. Now these are somewhat the porous polymers. Now these are found near the volcanoes naturally. Now these natural zeolites, they have some less spores. Pores, do you know pores? Means porous structure is there. Now here synthetic zeolites, they can be prepared in a laboratory by adding soda ash, feldspar and china clay. All these materials, they are heated together, then we get the synthetic zeolites. Now these have some properties. They have, as we seen in our general formula, that there is a sodium, and sodium is a more exchangeable anion, sorry, it is a cation, exchangeable cation means it has capacity to exchange the another ion. It gives its place easily to the another ion, and this property is used in the zeolite method for the water softening. Now here what happens actually, we here synthetic zeolite have many pores and it has capacity to exchange. Now the principle behind the zeolite method is that the water is percolated through a zeolite bed at a specified rate. Then what happens here, the whatever the hard water containing ions are there, means calcium and magnesium ions, those are exchanged, replaced by sodium ion. Those are trapped in the pores of the zeolite and the water get softened up. These diagram explain us the zeolite method, how it is carried out. Here the hard water inlet is there, then hard water is poured from a top of the tank. Zeolite bed is here, some coarse gravels are spread near the zeolite bed so that whatever the suspended materials are there, those can be trapped into these gravels. Now here, when this water passes through this zeolite bed, it is kept for some time in contact with the zeolite bed. Then what happens? The calcium and magnesium ions are captured or replaced by Na, and whatever the remaining part of that calcium and magnesium is there, that reacts with the Na and that salt is given in the water. Now here other salt comes as it is, but the hardness causing Ca and Mg, those are removed, so it is called as a water softening method. Now what happens actually, after some time all the pores, those are blocked, means all the sites of sodium, those are blocked with the calcium and magnesium. This time zeolite bed becomes inactive. Then what happens actually, here we can regenerate easily this bed. How? The NaCl solution, means our common salt solution, is taken here and that is injected. Again, as we have passed the water at specified rate, similarly we have to pass the solution of NaCl, that is our common salt solution is passed through this zeolite bed. Then process is reversed, means previously what happened, all the Na sites, Na is getting free and Ca and Mg are attached there. Okay, now what happens here, we are passing salt solution, then all the Ca and Mg, they are released and again that pores, that Na place is filled by again Na, that is sodium, and after this, after some time, all the Ca and Mg, they are given out. Again this is washed with the deionized water, all the Ca and Mg water is given out and zeolite bed is again ready to use for us. Okay. Now here procedure is mentioned shortly in this PPT. Now these reactions takes place, these are the schematic reactions where Na2ZeO means sodium zeolite, originally zeolite, which reacts with the calcium bicarbonate to give calcium zeolite and sodium bicarbonate. Similarly magnesium bicarbonate reacts with the zeolite and give magnesium zeolite, give, and again it gives the salt sodium bicarbonate, which is present in our soft water. Now why we are going to say this is a softening method, because it captures Ca and Mg, the effect of Ca and Mg. What is the definition of the hardness? Hardness is a soap destroying property. Now these Ca and Mg, those are going to affect the action of the soap, and that is avoided by this procedure, means Ca and Mg are removed. So this is the water softening method, and this is widely used water softening method. This method is very cheap method, means cost of this method, costing of this method is very low and it is widely used. We have discussed the regeneration also. Zeolites are easily regenerated by brine solution, that is 10% salt solution. Okay, now again here is reaction is mentioned here, means exhausted zeolite means what? All the Na places, sodium places are filled by calcium or magnesium, then that zeolite is called as an exhausted method. Now this exhausted method again treated with a, these exhausted zeolites, they are treated with the NaCl. Then we get again reclaimed a zeolite and washings are given out. This reaction, schematic reaction, explains the regeneration of the zeolite. Now this is another reaction which also explains the regeneration of zeolite. The washings are again drained out and zeolite is ready to use again and again. Now advantages of this process, it removes hardness almost completely and water of about 10 ppm hardness is produced. The equipment used in each compact occupy a very small place. We need one big tank and zeolite bed is there and it requires small space. No impurities are precipitated, no any precipitate is there, we get clear water. So there is no danger of sludge formation in the treated water at later stages. Now why this sentence is here, we can discuss this in our next procedure, that is lime soda process. Because in that process, large amount of sludge will be formed up and that sludge management is a big question of that procedure. Now here that threat is not here, sludge is not formed up and only clear water we get. The process automatically adjusts itself for variation in hardness of incoming water. Means here any hardness water can be treated. It is quite clean, there is no any no any precipitate formation. It requires less time for softening. It requires less skill for maintenance. There is no any maintenance needed for this procedure. So this is a very popular procedure of the water softening method. Limitations. Now every procedure, every method have some limitations also. If supply of water is turbid, then suspended matter must be. If supply of water is turbid, then suspended matter must be removed by coagulation. Now here, turbidity will block the pores of the zeolite. So to avoid, we have to treat the turbid water first and then only we can treat that water in the zeolite method. Now here, if water contains large quantities of colored ions such as manganese and Fe, in some hard water, manganese and iron ions are also present. Then that type of hard water cannot be treated in zeolite because it cannot be regenerated again by a simple NaCl solution. Only Ca and Mg are going to be replaced by the Na. But Mn and Fe, those form a permanent zeolites of manganese zeolite and iron zeolite. So we cannot treat this type of hard water in this process. Again, third limitation is that mineral acids, if present in the water, those destroy the zeolite bed as it is basic in nature. When it comes in contact with the acid, then what happens? It will neutralize the sodium and the exchange property will be reduced. So we can't treat acidic water into the zeolite method. Now disadvantages means what? As we discussed, only Ca and Mg, those are going to replace. Then what will happen? Sodium will be given out in the water. Means our water will contain extra sodium. So high turbid water cannot be treated here. Again, sodium will remain as it is in the water. These are some disadvantages. One more disadvantage is that The acidic water become more acidic, which cannot be treated for the boilers, because boilers, water boilers, boilers are the big tanks where steam formation, steam is generated. And what happens here? It is boiling all the time. Steam is generated all the time. Then what happens? Whatever the salts are present, sodium salts, those are going to precipitate, and those will form an inner layer, and that is called as a sodium embrittlement. And to avoid, we have to minimize the amount of sodium, and that is not possible in the zeolite method. So this is one of the disadvantage of this method. So these are some advantages and disadvantages of the zeolite method. Though these are disadvantages, but whenever there is any question of boiler or use of water for the boiler, then what happens? We can use domestically or in any industries for softening of water. This zeolite method is widely used. And this is the first method of water softening. In our next video lecture, we are going to discuss the another one, that is ion exchange method, where whatever the disadvantages are seen here, those are going to minimize in that method. So thank you. If you have any difficulty, you can contact me. Thank you.